Hi, Apple Valley High School students. It's Mr. Lee, and I'm gonna talk about the different machines in the Fab Lab. I'm gonna show you how many machines we have, their cost, their primary use, and then what materials they use. The first one is our 40-watt laser engraver. It's a universal laser systems. It costs about $35,000. Pretty much a workhorse of the Fab Lab. We use it for a lot of different things. Primary use is to cut and engrave on all kinds of different materials. We can even engrave on metals if we have a special tape. So we also have a 30-watt laser engraver, and that one's portable, and that uses the same materials. It can cut and engrave on different types of materials, and the cost of that one is about $25,000. Next up are our vinyl cutters. We have two of those. We have a Roland GS24 vinyl cutter, and then a Roland GX24. The difference between them is the GX24 is the older one. It cost about $2,500 when it was brand new. And the GS24 is the upgraded one. That one costs about $3,000 or about $3,500. Primary use for these are to cut vinyls for making stickers, or heat press vinyls for making shirts and hats and all kinds of things like that. Materials that they use, there's sticker vinyl and heat press vinyl. And what I have in front of you, kind of standing up on edge, that's heat press vinyl. The sticker vinyl kind of looks like this. This is some of the sticker vinyl. And the next machine I'm going to talk about is our Roland BN20 print and cut vinyl cutter. That machine costs about $9,000. This is used to make stickers again, just like the other vinyl cutters, except this one will also print photo quality images onto it. So a lot of the stuff that you see hanging in the Fab Lab, like the sticker on the wall behind the machine, that was printed and cut on this machine. Primary use is for making stickers and heat press stickers, and that you can put on shirts and hats and all kinds of things like that. We can also wrap vehicles. The material right underneath it, that vinyl is for putting on cars. Pretty cool stuff. Next up, we have our fusion heat presses. We use these quite a bit for making t-shirts. We have two of these. These cost about $2,500 each. They're professional level heat presses. So they have different platens that you can put on them to put different materials. This is set up for heat pressing t-shirts. I've been doing that during our teacher workshop. Next up is our Evolvus card printer. I'm going to walk all the way around to where we have our card printer. It's by our laser printers for making paper copies. So this is the card printer. This machine cost about $1,500 when it was brand new, and that will print onto plastic cards. I can kind of show you that. This is what one of the cards looks like. You can print on both sides, and you can do full color images. You can use this for making ID cards, or you can do all kinds of things with that. Primary materials that this uses are those plastic cards that I showed you. Next up is our 3D printers. We have lots of 3D printers in the Fab Lab. The two most used printers are the Replicator 5th Gen and then the Replicator Plus. And they are different. They have the Replicator Pluses are a newer machine than the fifth gen ones. We have 13 Replicator Pluses, and we have six Replicator Pluses and 13 fifth generation machines in the Fab Lab. These are primarily prototyping 3D printers. They use a material called PLA, which stands for polylactic acid, but all you need to remember is that it just stands for PLA. That comes in a roll. It's about 2 pounds. The rolls are held in the back of the printer, so you can kind of see what that looks like. Primary use for these machines are making just about anything three-dimensional. Very, very cool machines. We will use those quite a bit in our class. And I picked up 4 more that another school thought were damaged, but they really just needed some parts. So we got 4 more for free. Next up, the difference between the two printers, the fifth gen and the Replicator Plus, is that the Replicator Pluses work about 20% faster than the fifth gen. And when you're prepping the files, you have to actually make sure that you have the right type of printer selected, and we'll go through that when we learn how to use them. Next up is our Makerbot 2X. And the Makerbot 2X is actually an older generation 3D printer that Makerbot added 2 extruders. So this will actually print 2 types of filament at one time. You can either put 2 different colors of ABS plastic, or you can put in a ABS plastic and a dissolvable filament, which is pretty cool. The cost of these machines are about, of this one is about $5,000. The fifth gen, I forgot to tell you, the fifth gen MakerBots, they retailed for about $2,500 to $3,000 when they were brand new. And then the Replicator Pluses, they retailed for about $3,500 when they're brand new. Primary use for the 2X 3D printer is for prototyping again, but because it uses ABS plastic, it can do more higher end type of printing than the MakerBots do. Next 3D printer is our Z18, and that's in the corner of the room. It's actually running right now because we're making frames for our flute players at school because of the COVID pandemic. So here's what a frame looks like that we are printing. It's a 5-hour print to do that. We're about 44% complete in that print. And you can maybe see the print head moving in there. This machine costs about $6,000 to $7,000 brand new. Primary material that it uses is PLA, so it's the same material that the fifth gen and the Replicator Pluses use. What makes this unique to the other 3D printers is you notice how tall it is. Well, the Z is the letter that we use to represent vertical height. And 18 means 18 inches. So this will print things that can be up to 18 inches tall. So that's what's kind of unique about that machine. Pretty cool machine. It can print some neat stuff. And that's it for the first part of the lab. I'm gonna end this video now and then start it again for part 2, which will go through some of the other machines.